Hello dear all. So in this presentation, I will be discussing Kant's 12th chapter, that is the removal of totality of symptoms means the removal of the cause. Let's see what Dr. Kant teaches us. So reference of aphorism number 17 is given. Cure is effected by the removal of the whole of the perceptible signs and symptoms of the disease. The internal alteration of the vital force to which the disease is due, consequently the whole of the disease, is at the same time removed. It follows that the physician has only to remove the whole of the symptoms in order at the same time to abrogate and annihilate the internal change, that is to say, the morbid derangement of vital force. The totality of the disease is the disease itself. So what Dr. Hahnemann is teaching us in the aphorism number 17 is nothing but what is cure? Cure is removal of the perceptible signs and symptoms of the disease, number one. And most important is the internal alteration, means the vital force has altered, it is disordered. So the alteration of this disordered vital force again back to normal is cure. Hence, cure is removal of signs and symptoms, and this will only take place only if you are able to reset, you are able to cure the internal disordered vital force. So our remedies should correct the internal disorder vital force. Okay, then the internal disorder vital force has represented itself in the form of totality of symptoms. So cure is to restore this internal disordered vital force, and automatically the totality of the disease, that is signs and symptoms, will automatically get cured, they disappear. When the disease is annihilated, annihilated means it is removed, the health is restored, and this is the highest, the sole aim of the physician who knows the true object of his mission, which consists not in the learned sounding prating, but in giving aid to the sick. So the sole aim of the physician is to restore the sick to health. So it is his mission. So what is the mission? That the disease should be annihilated. That means the signs and symptoms should be removed. And when these signs and symptoms will be removed? When the internal derangement of vital force is removed. So the derangement is cured. So removal of this internal derangement is nothing but cure. So once this disordered vital force is cured, automatically the signs and symptoms disappear, and this should be the sole aim of the physician, which is his mission. Now see further. Causes continue in effects into ultimates. Means what? The causes of disease are having the effects on the organs. And this organ pathology which develops is called as ultimate of the disease. So ultimate means what? Effects of the disease. Now where is the disease then? The disease is prior to the organ pathology. So the disease is the causes. So causes of disease most important. So disease is not just visible signs or symptoms. Disease is prior to it, and disease is caused by certain causes. Now let's understand what are these causes. The causes are nothing but dynamic derangement of vital force. And why there is dynamic derangement in chronic disease? The dynamic derangement is caused by the miasms. Miasms are the defects which are produced by the inheritance. So the causes are beginning in the interior of man, in the disordered vital force. And where is this internal disordered vital force? It is invisible. Hence, causes begin in invisible interior of man. We have already seen in the previous discussion of the Kane's chapters that causes are beginning in the center. And where is the center? The center is in the central nervous system, in the cerebrum and spinal cord. It means that the central nervous system having the control of various operations of body. And the most important is the Kane's view that the sickness begins in the mind. The sickness begins in the thoughts. So faulty willing and thinking leads to the sickness. And Dr. Kane is saying that there are no diseases but only sick people. So remember, the causes of diseases are invisible, and these invisible causes have effects on the organs which become visible. So homeopathy will treat these causes. Now how do we treat these causes? The causes are invisible, but they are perceived by the homeopathic physician. And how does he perceive? He perceives by understanding patient's mental general and physical general symptoms. So let's continue further. All ultimates contain the cause of the beginning. Very important statement. So the ultimates means what? The organ pathology. And these organ pathology develops due to certain causes. And their causes are in this organ pathology. So ultimates contain the cause of the beginning. Let's go further so we understand this in better way. Rational man would assume that the removal of symptoms would remove the cause. So removal of symptoms is removal of the cause. Means what? The causes are in the symptoms. So the logical explanation of the statement is removal of symptoms is removal of the cause. Means what? All these symptoms which represent the disease also contain the causes. In large number of symptoms are of diseased ovary. If it is removed, they would manifest in some different parts, some another weak organ. So example is given that there is a pathology of ovary. So usually the modern medicine or old school treats it by the removal of ovary. Surgery is performed. But what is the result? Thus, the disease goes to the different parts, because the disease, that is the cause of this diseased ovary, is removed, but it is just the ovary is removed and the causes will still go on affecting now the other organs. Now, what homeopathy does? Homeopathy does the cure, which is from this cause, which is from this center, and thus the interior of the man is cured and automatically the organ pathology also regresses. It is serious matter to remove any diseased organ. This leads to suppression. This you already know. If surgeon removes structurally damaged knee joint, while there are corresponding structural changes in kidney, liver, which he cannot remove, they will get worse after removal of knee. So this example is also quoted by Dr. Kent. In case of TB lungs, it will remain in quiet state so long fistula in anus keeps on discharging. Allopath closes this vent. Vent is opening, and immediately there is infiltration of lungs and patient is coming near to death. So if the fistula is closed surgically, then the disease is traveling back to the lungs in increased intensity and patient is coming to near death. Unless causes are removed from beginning, from its beginning to end, the disease can reproduce itself. So the causes has to be removed from beginning to end. Otherwise, the disease can reproduce itself. It is very common that if the operation of hemorrhoids is performed, then after few years, again the patient develops hemorrhoids. So if the warts are removed after few years, for a few months, the warts again reappear. So the disease reproduces itself. Dr. Hahnemann says, cure means permanent removal of symptoms. Removing the cause and turning the disorder into order, and as a consequence, the results of diseases are removed. Thus, Dr. Hahnemann is giving us the very important guidelines that cure is permanent removal of symptoms. Removing the cause and turning the disorder into order. And as a consequence, the results of disease, that is the ultimates of disease, that is nothing but organ pathology, is also removed. But not by surgery. It is only possible when homeopath is administering the remedy internally. So totality of symptoms, what actually it means? Totality of symptoms is the entire representation of the disease and of the drug. So here it means that the totality of symptoms is of the patient who is having disease, and also totality of symptoms is constructed in the materia medica after the provers are noting down their symptoms, and there is a materia medica is formed. It is all that is visible represents the disease to the eye by touch. This is the concept in the modern medicine or allopathy. It brings clear idea to the mind about nature of sickness. So, the nature of sickness is just what is visible, but this is only for the allopath. Totality must be obtained, for there is no other means of ascertaining the nature of the remedy as given in aphorism number 18. So, the totality has to be constructed by the physician of the patient, and also it should be constructed by the physician when he is conducting drug proving. So, the remedy image can be matched with the image of patient's totality. So, let's see aphorism number 18. From this indubitable truth that besides the totality of the symptoms, nothing can by any means be discovered in disease, wherewith they could express their need of aid, it follows undeniably that the sum of all the symptoms in each individual case of disease must be the sole indication, the sole guide to direct us the choice of remedy. So we all know this, that the sum of the symptoms of the individual case must be the sole indication to choice the similimum. In the totality of symptoms must be identified, aphorism 19, where medicines have power to alter man's state of health, they are capable of curing disease state. So, the aphorism 19 states that medicines have power to alter man's state of health. We know that homeopathic drug proving is done by potentized medicines. Thus, they alter man's state of health. They are also capable of curing the same disease, same symptoms in the disease state. Medicines can restore the order in the economy. The potency must be consistent with the susceptibility. The potency must be consistent with the susceptibility. So, we already know that various potencies have the dynamic degrees, which correspond to the dynamic interior of man, and that is nothing but simple substance. So, in the chapter of simple substance, Dr. Kent has already told us that this simple substance means our vital force has degrees. So, degrees means what? It is corresponding to the qualitative aspect of the individual. And what is this qualitative aspect? These degrees are representing the degree of vital force, susceptibility of the individual. It is seldom means rare, that the potency is too high than the required, but it cannot be made so small as it won't act. So, it is a truth about the potency, that we are selecting the remedy with potency which will just sufficient to stimulate the vital force. It will be just sufficient to stimulate vital force, and it will be able to produce artificial similar disease slightly stronger than the natural disease. The decision of potency is done by assessment of susceptibility. Again, susceptibility is a qualitative property. It is not quantity. Hence, the assessment of the susceptibility for determination of potency is a qualitative aspect. Hence, the decision of potency is on the qualitative aspect, not calculation of any quantity of weight of patient. So, the selection of potency is done not so small, otherwise it will not be able to produce stronger artificial disease. And it should not be too high also, otherwise it will cause the homeopathic aggravation. Examples: there are patients who are not affected by single drop of coffee tincture but are extremely susceptible to the higher potencies of coffee. Such patients are made sick by large quantity of coffee. There are people not affected by crude lycopodium but in higher potencies is capable of affecting almost everyone. We all know that potentization is able to cause the liberation of hidden curative powers in the drug substance. Thus, the lycopodium in the higher potency is capable of affecting almost everyone. The effect that medicines have upon sick in restoring order can best be observed by inducing the effects upon healthy individual. Thus, we know the effects of medicines on the healthy individual. We call it as experiment of drug proving. In old school, drugs are not proved on healthy human beings, but it's proved on lower animals. The drugs are given on empirical basis. What is empirical basis? It is nothing but past experience and experiment of the physician. Thus, if the physician knows that this XYZ medicine was able to cure, say, typhoid. So again, every patient of typhoid, I will give this XYZ medicine. This is empirical basis. It does not have any law principle. So it is not based on any laws and principles. It is not scientific. Thus, the old school physician may change the drugs. Aphorism 20, the spirit-like power to alter the man's state of health lies hidden in the inner nature of medicines, can never be discovered by us by a mere effect of reasons. It is only by experience of the phenomena it displays when acing in the state of health of man that we can become clearly cognizant of it. So this is the spirit-like power called as vital energy or life energy, which animates the material body. It is necessary to know how the drugs make the healthy man sick. Then only homeopath can use this drug to cure. So experiment of drug proving is very important and it can build the homeopathic materia medica. Homeopathic materia medica gives this valuable information necessary to homeopath. Old school materia medica is made up of the results of medicine upon the sick people, an unscientific guide and always fluctuating. It is not same. Whereas If you observe, if you prove ilium sepa on any number of healthy provers of different age, both the sex, it will produce same symptoms. Okay, but the various provers may not give all the symptoms. Thus, the homeopathic materia medica is rich by the effects of drugs on healthy human beings. So, let's understand the difference in homeopathy and in allopathy. So, homeopathy, it restores the central disorder of vital force, which is the cause. In allopathy, they consider the disease only on the body, which is visible, as the cause also in the outer world. Outer world here is the visible organ pathology, and inner world is nothing but the inner invisible causes. Homeopathy cures the inner world and allopathy removes the outer world. So if any wart, corn is there, they will cauterize it. If eczema is there, local application is done. Now they fail to understand, if eczema is there, it is not due to any causes outside, but it is due to the cause of internal derangement of vital energy, which expresses on the skin. So, whatever the derangement is internal, it cannot be removed by local application. But the physician in allopathy fails to understand these. Thus, he removes the organs which is diseased, closes the fistula, and for him, this is the removal of totality. But the physician, he fails to understand that he is just closing the opening of the liberation of this disordered energy. So, this channel where the disorder energy was expressing itself on the outside on skin is closed, and now it finds its another way and starts affecting the other organs. In homeopathy, outer body comes to the normal state is the removal of totality. This is done by administration of internal medicine, not by any local application or surgery or by cauterization. Thus, what is removal of totality? Is removal of cause means, because when you are removing the totality by administration of similimum internally, the patient is cured, because homeopathy treats the cause and totality of symptoms already have the causes, right? So totality contains the causes, hence the removal of totality is removal of cause. Thank you. So this was for the understanding of this concept, that the removal of totality is removal of cause, because totality contains the causes. Thank you.